As a proof that even the smartest among us can be stupid at times lies the Demon Core. Demon Core was 6.2 kilogram subcritical mass of plutonium. First of all, what does subcritical even mean? This is an atom of plutonium. As you know, when you split an atom, you release a lot of energy. At this stage, this atom is highly unstable. It wants to split apart, but it can't do that. To make it split, you bombard it with neutrons. When atom splits apart, other than energy, it also shoots out neutrons in all directions. When these neutrons hit other atoms, they too become unstable and they also split apart, releasing even more neutrons, and the cycle continues. This is what critical mass means. On the other hand, because of many different factors, subcritical mass can do this. Most of these neutrons just fly out without hitting other atoms. To make them do that, you can surround the mass of fissile material with a neutron reflector. By doing this, neutrons bounce off and go straight back in, and thus increasing a chance for this chain reaction to happen at all. But just how much you need to enclose this mass for it to go from being subcritical to critical? That's what scientists at Los Alamos were trying to find out. On August 21st, 1945, Henry Dillingham was trying an experiment where he would lay bricks of neutron reflecting material around the Demon Core, and then with each brick placed around the core, he measured how closer the core would go to criticality. And then he dropped one brick right on top of the core, causing it to go critical for a few seconds. Of course, the core didn't explode, but even without that, Henry received a fatal dose of radiation and he died 25 days later. After this accident, you would think that people would say to themselves, this stuff is very dangerous, let's be a bit more careful in the future. The Demon Core was the third core in development. First two were dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and this one was scheduled to be dropped on August 19th. Luckily, Japan surrendered on August 15th, so this one wasn't used. Less than a year later, a physicist, Louis Slotin, was performing a test similar to the one performed earlier, but instead of bricks, they used two half spheres of beryllium, which is also a neutron reflecting material. Of course, the spheres had spacers that would prevent the spheres from completely enclosing the core. And of course, who needs them? Let's work without them. But the thing that simply baffled me when I read it was the way that Slotin was controlling just how much the sphere will enclose the core. He was using a screwdriver. A screwdriver, yeah. On May 21st, 1946, Slotin's screwdriver slipped just a tiny bit, allowing the top sphere to completely enclose the core. Instantaneously, there was a flash of blue light and a wave of heat across the room. The core had become supercritical. Not critical, you see, but supercritical. He quickly flipped the top shell to the floor, but it was just too late. In just a second or two, he received a lethal dose of radiation and he died 9 days later. The core was finally put to use 1 month later in the first nuclear testing after the Second World War. I'll see you next time.